Take a chance. Take a dare. Play the game of Double Dare with the host of Double Dare, Alex Trebek.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to Double Dare, a game of knowledge and nerve. You'll see how that works in our main game in just a little while, but right now we're going to go to our bonus round. For the first time in over a week, we crowned a new champion. It occurred on our last show, and he's coming out now to try and win $5,000. So if you will, a warm round of applause for Mr. Michael Cowell. Michael, how are you? Stand right next to me for a moment. I want you to tell me how you feel today going to the spoilers to try for $5,000.
Well, I'm excited and eager to try them.
You went right by me into the position we usually assume when we're going to do that. So let's do that right now as we introduce the spoilers. Come on back here. I hear some people laughing in the audience already. Well, let me explain for your benefit, since you might be joining us for the very first time, that the reason we call these people spoilers is because they will win money if they can keep our champion from winning money. Each of our spoilers is a PhD, and I want to introduce them right now. First of all, spoiler number one is Dr. Perry Thorndike. Spoiler number two is Dr. Barry Retia. And spoiler number three is Dr. Jim Brock. There they are, the spoilers. Let's close them off right now so they can't hear what we are saying. Now, how do we go about beating the spoilers for $5,000? On this board here, Michael, as you know, we have 8 clues to the identity of a person, place, or thing. Your job, give 4 of the clues to the spoilers. Each time a spoiler makes a mistake or doesn't know the right answer, then you win $100. If you can get 4 clues past any one spoiler without him coming up with the right answer, then you will win $5,000. And our last champion did it on 3 separate occasions, so there's no reason why you can't do the same thing. Let's look at the top of the board and see the correct answer. Subject is Neil Simon, obviously a person. Now, there are 8 clues up there. I said you have to give away 4 clues. That will allow you 4 passes. Pick a clue and let's go to work.
I'll start with number 5.
4 movies. He wrote The Heartbreak Kid and Murder by Death. Do you want to give the spoilers that clue, or would you like to pass on that?
I think I have to pass on that one.
Fine. 1 pass down. Pick another.
Number 7.
He created The Odd Couple and The Sunshine Boys.
Still risky. I'll pass.
Okay. 2 passes used up. You have 2 more to go.
Number 1.
He's known as Doc because of his boyhood ambition. Now, that doesn't seem like a bad clue, but it's up to you to decide.
I have to try that one.
Fine. Let's bring on the spoilers. Spoilers, the subject is a person, and here is the first clue. He's known as Doc because of a boyhood ambition. Let's hear from spoiler number 1 first. Dr. Thorndike.
No answer.
No answer. All right, that's $100 in cash for our champion. We go to spoiler number 2. Dr. Retia.
No answer.
Good. $200. Spoiler number 3, Dr. Brock. You have an answer.
No answer.
All right, $300. You've given away 1 clue. Pick another.
Number 2.
Number 2. He calls Plaza Suite his first attempt at serious writing and was depressed when everyone thought it was merely hilarious.
The audience's advice and pass.
Pass that one. All right. You've used 3 passes. If you're worried about the fact that you've used up 3 passes, don't be. We had 1 champion use up 4 passes, give away consecutive clues, and wind up with the $5,000. So it could happen right now.
Number 4.
Probably Broadway's most successful comic playwright.
I'll try that.
All right. Spoilers, here is the clue. Probably Broadway's most successful comic playwright. Let's go to spoiler number 1.
Neil Simon.
You have just won $100. You got the right answer. The other spoilers did not hear his answer, so we're still in good shape. Let's go to spoiler number 2. Do you have an answer? Need an answer now?
No answer.
Okay, good. That's 100. You got it by him. Let's go to Dr. Brock in booth number 3. Your answer.
Neil Simon.
Dr. Brock, that's right. And you have just won $100. Okay, we're going to be dealing with 1 spoiler only. You've got $400 in cash, and you've given away 2 clues. Pick another.
Number 8.
In a recent movie based on one of his hits, George Burns says, "Knock, knock," and Walter Matthau will only answer, "Enter!" or something like that.
I'll try it.
Try that? Okay. Spoiler, here is the clue. In a recent movie based on one of his hits, George Burns says, "Knock, knock," and Walter Matthau will only answer, "Enter!"
Mike Nichols?
You are incorrect. That's another $100 for you. You've given away three. You've used three passes. Two clues remain. All you have to do is get one of those clues past this spoiler, and you'll win $5,000.
What's it going to be? Let's try three.
In the first act of one of his hits, a poker player says, "Hey, Oscar, let's make a rule. Every 6 months, you have to buy fresh potato chips." You want to give that? Or do you want to pass? If you pass, you'll use your last pass, and you will then have to go with number six, sight unseen, as it were.
In spite of the audience's advice, I'm going to try that clue.
Okay, fine. Let's go to the spoiler. Here is the clue. In the first act of one of his hits, a poker player says, "Hey, Oscar, let's make a rule. Every 6 months, you have to buy fresh potato chips." Your answer, please, Dr. Rattea. I need an answer now. That's too much time and $5,000 for the man. Neil Simon is the right answer. And you now have $5,600. A great beginning. See how easy it is? Let us take a break for a commercial message, and we'll start a brand new match on Double Dare. Stay tuned, won't you, folks?
Time to meet us on the BUZZR Casino floor for Match Game. Gene Rayburn and the Stars, playoff to payoff. But will their pay lines hit the jackpot? Cash out with Match Game, starting Monday at 10 p.m. on BUZZR Casino.
Brand new champion in Michael Cowell. He is now in the champion's booth. And Michael, you've had the best beginning of any player ever on Double Dare. Now, our history is a short one, but still $5,600 to start off with is excellent. I want to wish you good luck in your new match as our champion. Here is your challenger.
Challenging Michael Cowell is Nancy King.
Hi, Nancy. Hi. I do see a wedding ring, don't I?
Yes.
You are married?
Yes. I have two children.
How old are they?
Emily is 8 and a half and Kate is 4.
They give you a lot of trouble?
No, they're very good.
Very good?
Yes.
Okay. Do you work in addition to your housework?
I do a lot of volunteer work, mostly in hospitals.
Okay. You get out in the community a lot?
Yes.
All right. That's very nice. I want to wish you good luck.
Thank you.
You're in against a champion who has won $5,600 to this point. While I'm on the subject of cash, I will mention for your benefit and for the benefit of our viewers that a game is $500. All right? Here we go. We're going to start off, folks, by showing you the correct answer. So if you'd like to play along with our contestants, then turn away from the screen for just a moment until you hear the chime, and then it'll be all right. Here is the right answer to our first subject. And the first subject is a thing. Let's go, players. Clue number one. It existed from November of 1936 to December of 1972. Second clue. Alfred Eisenstadt and Margaret Bourke White contributed greatly to its success. Moving along to clue number three. Among its occasional features were The World We Live In, The Epic of Man, and The World's Great Religions. Clue number four. Its 18 million photographs constitute the largest index treasure of its kind in existence, and that's the challenger's buzzer. She has sealed the champion's booth. He can't see or hear what's happening right now. Nancy, your answer?
National Geographic?
You are wrong. National Geographic is incorrect, so we close you off and we bring Michael back. Nancy gave us a wrong answer, Michael, so that's good news for you because you get a look at the next clue all by yourself, and we'll give you a free guess as well. Here is the clue. Its pinup photo of bit player Chili Williams in a polka dot bathing suit drew 100,000 letters in 1943.
Is it Life magazine?
It is, yes, indeed. Michael, you're back to answering with a question. But that's okay. It's correct. You have $50 in cash. Now, this penalty clue, which Nancy has not seen, now becomes the dare clue as well. You are in a dare situation. Do you want to take the dare and show her this clue, or would you like us to stop here?
I'll take the dare.
Okay. If she doesn't get the answer, you'll win $100 more. Let's bring Nancy back in. Got a very brave champion there. Michael got the right answer, and he's taken the dare. You've got 5 seconds, Nancy, to look at this clue. What do you say?
Life magazine.
You are right. Life magazine it is. $50 for each of you. Michael, you had no way of knowing, of course, that Nancy was in the right area because when she buzzed in a few moments ago, her answer was National Geographic. So she was, you know, in close there, in the right area. And each of you has $50, and we go on to another subject and another correct answer for you to look at. A thing, once again. Here is the first clue to assist you. In 1966, Vincent Canby wrote, it has become a way of life, if not actually a religion. Clue number two. Captain Cook was the first Westerner to describe it after he saw one version in Polynesia. Number three. In the slang used by participants, carving up the mob means riding through a crowd. That's Michael Cowell, our champion.
Surfing.
You're right. Surfing it is. Another $50 for you. You're up to 100. And it's a dare situation. You can double your score right now. Let's look at the clue. No man had a greater influence on this activity's modern course than sports hero Duke Kahanamoku. Well, do you want to take the dare?
I'll take the dare.
Fine. Let's bring Nancy back in. He got the right answer. He's taking the dare. You've got 5 seconds to look at this. Nancy's looking at me as if she knows the answer.
Surfing.
You're right. You do know the answer. And the game is all tied up again. $100 for each of our players, and I think this is a good point at which to take a commercial break. So we'll do that. We'll return with more on Double Dare.
Grab a hot cup of Joe, Bud, John, and Gary, and throw away all your cares. You owe it to yourself to take a break.
I think that's cozy.
BUZZR's Black and White Coffee Break. Weekdays, 2 Eastern, 11 Pacific. The laundry can wait. Let's play, baby.
It's all tied up here on Double Dare today. $100 for the champion, Michael Cowell. $100 also for Nancy King, our challenger. We've got another right answer for you to look at for our next subject. This time, players, we are looking for a person. Here we go. Clue number one. He won 6 cents in a libel suit against the Chicago Tribune. Clue number two. Though he was not a publisher, he owned the Dearborn, Michigan Independent. Clue number three. He built a museum for his friend Thomas Edison. Number four. He took a shipload of pacifists to Europe in 1915 to try to end the war. Clue number five. Workers in his factory were forbidden to smoke or drink. Moving along, clue number six. History is bunk. Now we've got an answer, and that's Nancy's buzzer. What's the answer?
Ford.
Yes, Henry Ford is right. You've gotten $50 more. You're up to $150. Do you have a little frog in your throat there, Nancy? Have you cleared it?
Yes.
All right, you're in a dare situation. Let's look at the next clue. His grandson now runs the family business. That's the dare clue. You could pick up an additional $100 if you take the dare and it works. What do you want to do?
I'll take the dare.
Fine, let's bring the champion back. Got the right answer, taking the dare. Here's the clue for you. Michael?
Rockefeller?
Rockefeller is wrong, so we close you off. Nancy gets another 100. She's up to 250. Double dare time. A chance to go to $450 if it works. But first, let's look at the clue, then you can make up your mind. American industrialist who pioneered the use of the assembly line. Do you want us to stop on that one, Nancy, or are you going to be very courageous and take the double dare?
Oh, I think you get it on that one. I don't think I'll...
You want to stop?
Yes.
All right, let's bring Michael back. Nancy's up to $250. She is stopping, not going to take the double dare. The next clue, though, was... American industrialist who pioneered the use of the assembly line.
Henry Ford.
Yeah, she did the right thing then in stopping. Okay, I'm glad you agree, Michael. You are now trailing, however, by $150, and we're going on to another subject, and we have a right answer for you to look at. Give you one step up on our contestants. Here is the first clue. When this woman received advance notice of a 1925 kidnap plot, she began carrying around a Colt 45. That's the kind of woman to know. Clue number two. She said Hollywood was a small hick town when I arrived. Next. At the age of 32, she played a 12-year-old in the film Little Annie Rooney. Clue number four. When she and three others founded United Artists, one producer said the lunatics have taken charge of the asylum, and Nancy is first at the buzzer. What's the answer?
Mary Pickford.
You're right. Up to $300. You're getting there, slow but sure. Dare time for you, Nancy. I want you to take a careful look at this. For the film Coquette, she won the 1929 Best Actress Oscar. You've got $300. You could go to $400 if you take the dare and it works. If not, Michael would wind up with $150.
I'll take the dare.
Okay, let's bring Michael back. Sexy lady. Got the right answer? Taking the dare? Here is the clue for 5 seconds. What's your answer, Michael?
Katherine Hepburn.
Katherine Hepburn is wrong. We close you off, Nancy. It worked out beautifully. You now have $400 to Michael's $100, and it's Double Dare time. A chance for you to become the new champion. Here is the Double Dare clue. Four of her golden curls are to be found in museums in Los Angeles and San Diego. That's the Double Dare clue. If you take the Double Dare and it works, you wind up with $600. If it doesn't, Michael goes to $200. You'd still have a $200 margin.
I'll take the Double Dare.
All right. Let's bring Michael back. Double Dare time. Here is the clue for you. Michael?
Mary Pickford?
You are right, and you now have $200. Good going. Heartbreak, isn't it, Nancy? When you are standing there and not knowing his facial reactions, not knowing how he's reacting at all to any of this, but he came up with the right answer. You still have a $200 lead, and we are going to take a break for a few messages of interest.
Raver.
Hello there.
Dawson.
Survey set.
The Sass.
I don't mind your shedding tears of joy, but you're crying on my new suit.
The Class.
You gonna watch the telly tonight, are you?
The Long Mike.
That is absolutely correct.
The Longer Kiss.
I've gotten aroused.
Two originals, 2 hours.
The lunatics have taken over the asylum, so.
Match Game and Family Feud together again. Weekdays at 4, only on BUZZR.
You said it very well.
Let's play.
Welcome back to Double Dare. Normally, the champion fares much better than the challenger in the early going in a match because he or she has been around a little longer, but that's not the case in this current game. Michael Cowell, our champion, who so far on Double Dare has won $5,600, is trailing. He's got $200 so far in this game, but Nancy King, the challenger, has $400. We're going to go on to another subject, and we'll show the folks at home the right answer. The subject this time, players, is a person, and here comes clue number one to help you identify this individual. When a girl said to him, "I've never been out with anyone over 24, he said, "That's okay, neither have I." Clue number two. Some of his 48 servants don't see him for months at a time. That's Nancy King's buzzer. She has sealed Michael's booth. He can't see or hear what's going on right now. Nancy?
You Hefner?
You're right. You've got $450. You are just a dare away from becoming the new champion. Let's take a look at the dare clue. He eats, sleeps, and works on his bed. Now, you've got to think carefully about that one. Is that clue a giveaway, do you think? Or do you want to take the dare, take a chance on it, and see what happens?
I'll dare.
All right, let's bring Michael Cowell back. Nancy got the right answer. She's taken the dare. You'll have 5 seconds to look at the clue, and then if you give me anything but the right answer, she becomes our new champion. Here is the clue, Michael. And your answer is?
She's got me. I have no guess.
It's Hugh Hefner, and Nancy is our new champion with $550. Come out of there, Nancy. Michael, you're smiling, you're taking it like a good sport, and with good reason. You've got $200 now added to your previous winnings, $5,800 in cash for you, with our congratulations. Goodbye and good luck. Happy New Year. Nancy, congratulations. Luck had nothing to do with it. You were very, very good. What do you mean lucky? Why do you say that?
I just feel very lucky.
But why?
Just to be here, I think.
Just to be here? In this position as a winner?
Yes.
Well, I've got some more things that are going to be very good news for you, and you shouldn't be too surprised because you're going to get to play the spoilers for a possible $5,000. Do you want us to, you can tell us now, do you want to go home and just call it all off?
No, give it a try anyway.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what we're going to do first. We got to take a break for a commercial message or two, pay the rent on the studio, and then we'll come back with you, all right? Okay, let's do that, folks. We'll be back in 1 minute from now.
Be prepared to shout big bucks, no whammies, in the middle of the street and in the middle of dinner, because the Press Your Luck Mini Marathon is coming next.
Very nervous champion right here, Nancy King on Double Dare, and her hands are ice cold. Tell me about your answer, Hugh Hefner. Now, did you know that yourself, or is it because your husband reads a lot of his material?
No, he doesn't. I knew it myself.
You knew it yourself. Did you also know that Hugh Hefner started his Playboy enterprise when he was just 27 and he had $600 that he had borrowed from somebody else, and now it's a multi-million dollar operation?
No, I didn't know that.
That doesn't mean a thing to you. And I'll tell you what, we're going to give you a whole day in which to get more nervous or more relaxed. I'll let you decide what it's going to be. You come back on our next program, and we're going to start things off with you and the spoilers for a possible $5,000, okay? All right, folks, do join us then, won't you? Next time around on Double Dare.
Today's consolation prizes are first, Mr. Coffee with Revolutionary Coffee Saver. 10 cups for $2. Great coffee taste without coffee waste and genuine Mr. Coffee filter. And cosmetics from Mary Kay for your great skin care, including an assortment of Mary Kay creams, lotions, glamour makeup, and men's toilet base. And a spice rack from McCormick's, filling your house of flavor. The finest in spices, flavoring extracts, seasoning mixes, convenience foods, and cake decorations. And a supply of Safe Puff Pink Fabric Softener leaves you washable, soft, and fresh. Charles more absorbent, Safe Puff Pink, soft and absorbent. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Double Dare, a Mark Goodson-Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Love of Life next over most of these CBS stations.